Hello, beautiful and amazing people, badass Dark Zone agents, butchering the building as usual. Warm welcome to my channel and another crazy Division 2 build video. And today I will show you never ending DPS Seeker mine build. This one is absolutely ridiculous, and most of NPCs will leave the server. Check this out. I believe I can fly. I believe I can touch the... Okay, I will not destroy your hearing. Jesus Christ, I need some sleep, guys. Oh my goodness. I have 3 weeks year old son, and most I have slept is 2 hours per day. So I'm slowly losing my mental health. But anyway, this is not story about me, but about ridiculous Seeker mine build, which is little bit unusual, I shall say. So welcome to the insanity. Agents, I have to be honest, but I really liked Seeker mine setups previously. Before we received title update 12, I remember all the good days with 3.11.7 setups, where you had on the ropes, talent, technician specialization and unbreakable on chess piece. You had ridiculous skill power, so you would unlock basically all the best skills in the game, and Seeker mines in PvP were so dope because they chew your enemies in stagger animation, and I had a blast with that setup. I hardwired the build. Ooh, it got nerfed, man! It did some nasty damage. So I decide to create monstrous build, which is not your typical Seeker mine build, but it's so damn powerful and beautiful because we have weapon damage, survivability and no cooldown basically whatsoever for your Seeker mines. It depends on your animation or timing. Of course, I'm talking about Exotic Assault Rifle Chameleon, which will provide you with the best damage boost in the game. You could replace this one with Capacitor, but with that Adaptive Instincts talent on, man, this baby will hit like a truck. 90% weapon damage boost and crit damage boost alone will allow you to clear everything in the game with breeze. You will not feel any challenge whatsoever. You can clear heroic difficulty with direct will applied, farm resource convoys with this setup, guys. And my little dirty secret is Memento Backpack. The synergy is amazing, guys, here, because it will provide you with armor regen, bonus armor on kill, weapon damage boost, and most important part, skill efficiency. And that works really nice with your shield and Seeker mines. And when you will get those stacks, you will be unstoppable. But before we continue, I just wanna let you know that we have some sponsor items. Guys, if you don't have enough time or good teammates, but you still want to have all the best items in your game, then Deving.net is site for you. They have absolutely amazing team on Xbox. They will complete your order twice as fast. Now everything happens with account sharing. This service has been working for many years. It has tons of custom reviews. You can check everything by yourself, but now with my promo code RBDIV, you will have 15% discount on all services. It's an amazing deal, especially when right now this site supports a lot of games. And if you have any questions, I will leave a link down below in my description so you can contact them through the WhatsApp basically immediately. But now let's get back to new never-ending Seeker mine DPS build, guys. So what I'm running here is Intimidate with Memento Backpack. Intimidate in this case is really strong on heroic difficulty. Basically, you're gonna face tank whole waves with this setup and blow them up with your Seeker mines. But if you want to take this setup for legendary difficulty, I would recommend to go with Obliterate talent. Crit chance is not a problem with Exotic Assault Rifle Chameleon. You already have that attribute on that gun, so it's pretty safe bet. And I'm running Cheska on my chest piece, so crit chance is pretty nice here. And yeah, for legendary, just rock Obliterate or Unbreakable. It depends on your preference, but on heroic difficulty or open world activities, honestly, it doesn't matter. You can do whatever you like run with pistol, naked. Man, do what you do the best, I guess. So, simple as that. For survivability, we have a ridiculous basically boost from a mental backpack, and don't forget that you could run as well capacitor exotic assault rifle, which will increase with full stacks your skill damage by 60%, and from one skill tier you will receive 7.5% weapon damage boost. Or maybe run Scorpio shotgun, but then it's not that fun to me. At least I think it's not that fun. I really love assault rifles in the game. Chameleon looks so damn dope. It's super dope gun, man. One of the best looking guns in the game by far. And this setup is something fresh. And agents, if you want to be updated to all the best PvP, PvE builds, you know where you have to be, bastard. Hit that like, smash that sub. Smash that sub for my son, man! Come on, what kind of person do you wanna be? That one which doesn't give a like? For Butcher Magic? Okay, guys, do whatever you want. With no further ado, let's get into it. For specialization, we're gonna use Technician, because Technician specialization will provide us with one skill tier, which will improve our shield health and seeker mind damage. And of course, skill damage by itself is really nice from Technician specialization. And grenades are really handy on legendary difficulty, because they will stand all those annoying dogs and war machines. So Technician specialization basically is must have here. And seeker mines work really nice here. As you see, I have no cooldown whatsoever. It depends on my timing, when I want to release them. And man, just take a breath and destroy those mobs. They will leave the server, boy. This build is so fun, guys. It's out of the box, it's a little bit different than your typical skill build, and I would say it's not a skill build at all, but my main weapon is exotic assault rifle Chameleon with adaptive instinct talent, and baby, when this talent is on, oh, it will take you home, trust me, it will deal such amount of damage, it's ridiculous. 90% damage boost and 50% crit damage boost is absolutely outstanding, and crit chance is not a problem with this build, so you can easily face tank everybody. And basically, once you will get that bonus armor, which will proc intimidate talent on your chest piece, that's game over. But for legendary difficulty, guys, I would recommend you to use unbreakable or obliterate, because there will be not that easy to receive that bonus armor, so intimidate will be not active all the time, so use wisely chest piece talent, guys. For heroic difficulty, sure, go for intimidate. For second gun, I'm running test subject, name it assault rifle, it's perfect in sync. This will give you immediately 40% weapon damage boost and of course skill damage boost. But if you like capacitor, yeah, sure, you could run it, because with each skill tier you will have 7.5% weapon damage boost, and with full stack 60% skill damage boost. But this setup is created to run around like a freak and deal ridiculous damage with your guns, and then just send flying your enemies with the seeker mines. And for that purpose alone, Chameleon will do much better work, and synergy with skill damage is ridiculous. So Chameleon, I think, will do better job here, and you will have much more fun. For pistol, it doesn't matter, it depends on your preference, but now let's move to my gear. I'm running 4-piece hardwired set, but with 1.3 million armor, and that's really important, because that's a really nice sweet spot where you will receive pretty good amount of bonus armor on the kill, which will activate intimidate talent, and that can allow you to face tank enemies without shield. And again, that gives you mobility, that freedom, that you don't have to hide behind shield all the time, and that's really important in my gameplay. I want to feel that freedom, and when I feel that things will get heated, I will throw seeker mines, and trust me, this game is coded in a way that all the enemies will jump away or they're gonna explode, so you have those precious seconds to basically regather yourself, pull that medkit if it's necessary and keep going. So for chess piece, I'm running Cheshkov with Intimidate. Cheshkov will give me that crit chance, which is really important, but you could use maybe here Fenris, but I would recommend you to stick with Cheshkov. For holster, I'm running Hardwired holster with weapon damage here and skill damage as my attributes, guys. We still want to basically receive that nasty skill damage boost for my seekers, and my seekers can hit 2 mil per one, and if I will caught enemies in one place, they will all basically receive multiple damage from multiple seekers at the same time, and they will be flying all over the place. And for this reason, my mental backpack will work for us really well, because skill efficiency basically give us skill damage as well, and the synergy here is really nice. You will get 3% armor regen with full stacks and weapon damage boost from the mental backpack alone. For gloves, I'm running Hardwired gloves with armor core attribute, and we have, like I told you before, 1.3 million armor. And again, for knee pads, I'm running Hardwired for weapon damage. And skill damage is basically everywhere besides chest piece. Skill damage as my attribute for my Seeker Mines. My Mentor Backpack will boost our Seeker Mine damage even further, man. So pretty dope synergy. Don't forget that you have Intimidate for maximum weapon damage. And when you run Chameleon, which will give you 90% weapon damage boost, you don't have to worry about crit damage a bit, because you're gonna overpower everybody with raw weapon damage. And Hardwired by itself will give you skill haste, skill damage. It's really handy when you're gonna lose shield, for example. It will save you that precious time, and then just shoot Seeker Mines all over the place. Butcher is dropping the mic. See you in the next one. Enjoy this build.